All right, now that you've got your sequence over here, I want to talk a little bit about this timeline panel. And so I'm going to close this just to show you that when you double click a sequence in your project panel, it opens up in your timeline panel. And obviously, like I said earlier, this is where we're going to add clips and build your video footage. So to show you how this panel works, I'm just going to select a few clips here and add them to our timeline by dragging them over. All right, down here in our timeline panel, we've got this blue line here, and this is our playhead, and we can drag it around wherever we want. And then we've got these different rows down here, and these rows are called tracks. We've got this thick dividing line here, and above this line are our video tracks, and below this line are our audio tracks. Now I want you to go to the top of this first video track, and I want you to drag the top line of it up, and then you'll notice that that lets us see some thumbnails, some previews of our video footage there on the timeline. We can also drag the bottom line of our first audio track down, and then you'll see that that expands that track as well. But now let me collapse those again real fast, because I want to tell you that you can also press the Shift plus key on your keyboard to expand all the tracks at once, or you can press the Shift minus key to collapse them all at once. Or if you just want to expand or collapse one track, instead of dragging the line up, you can double click right here to the left of the track. All right, now let's talk about the order of the tracks. And we'll start with the order of the video tracks. So the video tracks work like layers in Photoshop or like pieces of paper that are stacked on top of each other. So the higher video tracks are going to show up on top of the lower video tracks. So if I have two clips that are the same size, like these two clips are both 1080p, and I put one on top of the other, then only the clip on track two is going to show up. And so that means that if I'm editing a video with somebody who's in an interview or somebody who's presenting, like here, then I'll often put my A-roll on track one, and then I'll put my relevant visuals, my B-roll, on track two, and I'll just sprinkle that in at times. And then if I have a graphic, like this cute little hand here, I'll stack that on top so that it layers on top. And then if I need to add a title, then that's usually going on my highest track. By the way, if you do cover something up on a lower track and you forgot what was under there, you can always press this I button here. You can click on that icon to hide a track, and then you can see what was underneath. Now again, below this dividing line, we've got audio tracks. And it doesn't matter what order your audio tracks are in, all the audio files are going to play at the same time. And so if we look at this here, we've got audio from our camera, and we've got two tracks here actually because it's in stereo. So we've got a track for left and for right. Here we've got audio from this mic here that's on the table. And again, it's also in stereo. And then down here at the bottom, we've got some music. And if I play this here, we're going to hear all of that audio at once. Don't worry, you're not gonna be doing it alone. We're gonna be doing it together phase by phase. So you'll notice we had everything playing at once, but let's say we didn't want that. So we could go over to this imp here, and that's gonna let us mute a track. So let's mute this left and right track from our camera, and then we'll play that back. Don't worry, you're not gonna be doing it alone. We're gonna be doing it together phase by phase. So that sounds much better, right? Or let's say we just wanted to work on the audio from my mic there on the table, then instead of pressing the M button, we could press this S button, which is to solo a track, and that's gonna let us only hear the audio from that track. But don't worry, you're not gonna be doing it alone. We're gonna be doing it together phase by phase. And so again, that was just my mic on the table, and so that's a little bit about how you control your audio tracks in Premiere. Now I want you to take your thumb, and I want you to pound it on the space bar. And you'll see that we're playing our video. And I pounded it again, and we paused our video. Play, pause, just like on YouTube, right? Now, where does your sequence play? It plays up here in a panel called the Program Monitor panel. So remember when your grandma used to say she had to watch her TV program? Well, this is the program that you're creating. So it plays in the Program Monitor panel. Now, if I go to the bottom right of this panel, you'll see that we've got playback resolution options. So we've got quarter, half, full, and of course we want full resolution, right? We want HD, baby. Well, I could have Premiere Pro play my timeline back at full resolution, but if you don't have a souped up computer or you're editing everything in 8K or you're gonna add a whole bunch of effects to the clips in your timeline or you wanna do all of these things and then you set the playback resolution to be full, then you might have some issues. Like the clips in your timeline are not gonna play back at regular speed. It's gonna be slow, choppy, and Premiere is gonna be like, girl, I can't. So if you do start seeing issues like that when you're playing footage in your timeline, one thing you can do is go down here to this playback resolution in your Program Monitor panel and drop it down to something like a half or a quarter, and that should help. And by the way, this playback resolution is not the final resolution that's gonna show up when you export your video. It's just what Premiere is showing you when you're editing your video. All right, on the bottom left of our Program Monitor panel, we've also got zoom options. So if we need to get all up in our video's business to do something extra close, we can use that. And we can use the scroll bars here to get around or the hand tool to grab our way around. But personally, I think all that takes way too long, and so I've got a little hack that is much faster, and it's this key at the top left of your keyboard. I call it the squiggle key. I think technically it's called the tilde key. Anyway, when you press that squiggle key, it's going to maximize any panel that you've got selected, or if you press it again, it's going to minimize any panel that you've got selected. And hitting that squiggle key is way faster than fooling with this zoom level down here. Another speed hack I use is that I've set my plus and minus keys on the keyboard to be shortcuts for zooming in and out in the program monitor panel. And I've also set the zero key to fit the video in view, and that also helps me fly through edits. Okay, so that concludes our little overview of the program monitor panel, and now we're gonna move on to transportation. Transportation is how you get from point A to point B, and it's really important in life, and it's really important in Premiere Pro. These tracks on the timeline are your open road, and you need to know how to zoom across them like you're trying to live your life and not be on the computer all day. And so let's talk about how to do that. So I want you to start by pressing the up and down arrows on your keyboard, and I want you to notice that when we do that, we can easily send our playhead to the start or end of a clip and quickly get around our timeline. And if for some reason the up and down arrows are not moving the playhead on your timeline, I want you to go over to the left side of your timeline where you see the letters V1, V2, and A1, and A2, and I want you to click beside those letters until they're highlighted in blue, both the V1 and the A1. And I'll explain why in a later lesson, but for now, just trust me, this should make the up and down arrows work. All right, the next thing you need to know is how to zoom in and out of your timeline, and you can do that by dragging this bar at the bottom here, and that's going to zoom in or out. And you can also use the zoom tool over here, and you can use that to click and drag on a certain part of your timeline, and you can option click to zoom out. But I don't zoom using either one of those. I use keyboard shortcuts because they're way faster. Now the default shortcut keys for zoom on the timeline are the minus and plus keys, but because those keys would cause my right hand to leave my mouse and I don't want that, I have reassigned those shortcut keys to be something better. So I've gone up to my Premiere Pro window in the top left of the application and I've gone to keyboard shortcuts. Then I have typed in the search bar zoom, and then under sequence we have zoom in and zoom out. And for those commands, I've set it to T and R because that's super easy for my left hand to get to and I use that shortcut all the time. So now I'll click OK, and now if we go back to our sequence and I press the R and the T keys, you'll see that I can zoom in and out on my sequence and it is so much faster. All right, so now I want you to zoom all the way in on your timeline, and then I want you to press the right arrow key on your keyboard as fast as you can. Do it over and over and over again, and you'll see that we're navigating through our video frame by frame, and the left arrow does the same thing, but backwards. And so those keys are really good if you wanna make fine cuts to your video. You can also move to the left and the right in your timeline by using the slider bar at the bottom of the timeline panel, but I think it's faster to use the hand tool over here, which you can also get to by pressing the H key, and that lets me quickly grab my way left and right in my timeline. Now I'm going to show you how to preview your footage in your timeline super fast, which is really important if you don't want editing to take forever, and I know you don't. All right, so of course you could drag your playhead through your timeline if you wanted to go like fast forward or fast rewind through your timeline. But of course there are shortcut keys that you could use to do this faster. So I've gone up to the Premiere Pro menu again in the top left, I've gone to keyboard shortcuts, and I have searched for the command called shuttle. Now it's called shuttle when you fast forward or fast rewind through your timeline because shuttling gets you from point A to point B really fast. So I've reset the shuttle left key, which is going to be our fast rewind key, to be the key S, and the shuttle right key, which is going to be our fast forward key, to be the key F, because those keys again are right under my left hand, so my right hand doesn't have to move from my mouse. Now if I press the F key once, it's going to play my video at normal speed. If I press the F key again, it's going to play it in fast forward, and if I press it again, in faster forward, and again in like super fast forward, which Premiere is now struggling to even keep up with. So if you were like FFFFF, it's gonna go 0 to 60 just like that. And the S key, our fast rewind key, is gonna do the same thing but backwards. So you press it once, it's gonna rewind normal speed, and again faster, and so on. All right, now let's go back and talk about how Premiere was struggling to play our timeline back when we were going super fast forward through it. Now for one thing, our playback resolution is set to full, so that's the first thing we could adjust, but there's something else we could do. And you'll notice that there is this yellow line up here on top of our timeline, and that is Premiere telling us, yo, I might have some trouble playing back this footage. So Premiere puts different colored lines at the top of your timeline to let you know how well it's gonna be able to play your footage back, and they work like traffic lights. A red line is Premiere telling you, don't even try that. This ain't gonna happen. I can't play this clip back. And this usually happens because you put a lot of effects on a clip. A yellow line is Premiere telling you, I probably got this, but this is kind of a weirder video format, and so don't be doing that super fast shuttling foolishness. And a green line means we good. Go ahead and put that playback resolution to full. I got this. So if Premiere is struggling to play back your footage quickly enough, you're gonna wanna turn those red and yellow lines into green lines, right? So how are you gonna do that? Well, you're gonna do that through a process called rendering. And rendering is a special process where Premiere takes your messy video clip that's in some difficult to read format and that you've added a ton of effects to, and then it turns it into a nice polished video clip that can be played back without any issues. Now, as this meme will tell you, rendering can sometimes take a while depending on how complex your sequence is or how much of a boss your computer is. And so sometimes it's best to render out just a little section of your timeline instead of the whole thing so it won't take forever. So we're gonna go over to this little hamburger menu beside our sequence name in the timeline panel. We're gonna click that, and then we're gonna make sure that work area bar is checked. And you'll notice that we have this little bar on the top of our timeline. All right, so we could take this work area bar and we could drag it in and out over certain areas of our timeline, and we could tell Premiere, yo, this is the area that we're working on right now. These two clips here under our work area bar. And so you'll notice here we got a red and yellow line under our work area bar here. We don't want that. We want a green line, and so we're gonna render that so that we can get a green line and have smooth playback. So to render, we're gonna go up to our sequence menu here, and you'll see that we've got two options for rendering. The first option is your first resort. So it's the option that's not gonna take as long, but it's not always gonna solve the problem. The second option might take a little longer, but it's always gonna get you a green line. And so that's the one that I always choose, so let's pick that as a safe bet. Now the line above our two clips is green, and we can fast forward through those babies at lightning speed if we want. All right, one last thing about the timeline for now. That magnet right there is how you turn on and off snapping. So when it's off and I try to add a clip and line it up with the last one in our timeline, then, oh y'all, this is testing my patience. But when it's on, everything snaps right into place and Mary is happy. So of course, I always want snapping to stay on to make my life easier, but my problem is that Premiere Pro has set the default shortcut to turn snapping on and off to the S key, which is like super easy to accidentally press, and so I have turned that off. I have gone into the Premiere Pro window at the top left and selected keyboard shortcuts, then I've searched for snap in the timeline, and I've made sure that I have deleted that default shortcut key. Yeah. Well, look at that, we've reached another triple P, which is another practice pause point, which means it is time to pause and practice doing the things on the screen, if you haven't been following along already, before you watch the rest of the lesson. So I want you to drag footage to your timeline, know how to set the playback resolution, expand and collapse the tracks on your timeline, press the up, down, and left, right arrow keys, make sure you can zoom in and out, practice using the fast forward and fast rewind keys. Remember FF for fast forward and SS for fast rewind. And then set your work area bar on the timeline and make sure you know how to render. And don't keep watching until you practice these things.